Subscribe our channel, press the bell icon for latest videos.
Hi friends, here in this video we are going to see how to draw a thermal circuit for a hollow composite cylinder using conduction heat transfer. For that, let's get started. Now, here there is a diagram in which there are three different materials, that is hollow cylinders having three different materials with thermal conductivities K1, K2 and K3 respectively. Or I can say that this material which is at the last, I denote its thermal conductivity with K3 and which is there inside with K1. This inside cylinder is having a radius of R1 and the outer radius is R2. Similarly, the next envelope is of R3 and the outer radius is R4. So these are the different radiuses and different materials having different thermal conductivities. Next, inside the cylinder the temperature would be T1. There would be some fluid, for example, inside this having temperature T1, and on the outside the temperature is T2. So the assumption here is T1 is greater than T2. Hence heat would be flowing from region of high temperature to the region of low temperature. It would get transferred in this direction, that is Q. Now to draw the thermal circuit, I'll start it in this way, that there are three different materials, so three different resistances, all are of conduction type. This is R1, R2 and R3. Then the temperature at the nodes, here the temperature is T1, on the other side it is T2. Assumption is T1 is greater than T2. So heat will always flow from high temperature towards the low temperature. Then I'll write the equation, that is from Fourier's law of heat conduction. Q would be written in a general way. In the numerator there will be temperature difference, that is T1 minus T2, and there are different resistances. Like first of all there is resistance R1 because of the first material, then R2 because of second, and R3 because of third. Next I'll write their values. R1 is, since it is a hollow cylinder, the formula of thermal resistance is 1 upon 2 pi K1 for the first material into L, that is the length of the cylinder, 1 upon 2 pi KL, ln of log to the base E of bigger radius upon smaller radius. Here for this inside cylinder of material 1, the outer radius is R2, that is the bigger radius, and inside radius is R1, so this would be R2 by R1. Next, for the second cylinder it would be 1 upon 2 pi K2 L, the length of the cylinder being same, ln of again bigger radius upon smaller radius. For this second cylinder the bigger radius is R3 and the inside radius is R2 for the second cylinder, so R3 by R2 plus 1 upon 2 pi K3 L, ln of, that is for the third cylinder, bigger radius upon smaller radius. Here the bigger radius is R4 and the inside radius of smaller radius for the last cylinder is R3, so R4 by R3. So these are the respective thermal resistances R1, R2 and R3. And finally, in a short form, this could be written as the temperature difference divided by the sum of all thermal resistances, which is the summation of thermal resistances. And this was the thermal circuit for the given condition. At the end, if you'll find my videos helpful, you can like, share, comment and subscribe our channel. And share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.